Hello 3ds Max users. In this video I'm going to show you how you can stop the menu bar being activated when Alt modifier key is pressed. First, let me reproduce the problem. So let's create a box or anything simple. And let's convert it to editable poly. And I really like working with Alt plus modifier, and I have it bind as a select loop. So Alt plus F and loop is selected, or Alt plus R and ring selection. And now let's say that I accidentally, for whatever reason, I exit the subobject mode and I press Alt F or Alt R. And here you can see these menus popping up. And I hate that. I really don't like that. So I want to disable that, and since you are watching this video, you want probably as well, and let me show you one of the solutions. So you gotta go to customize user interface, and you gotta go to menus tab, and you can see the list of all these menus that are actually represented here as well. And now let's right click and edit menu item name. And by default, you will see something like this. And in order to correct this thing and disable Alt modifier key opening up file, edit, and all other submenus, you have to check the customized file name. And by default, you have this ampersand sign in front of the menu name or menu label, and you want to delete that and press OK. And you have to do the same for the rest of submenus. And now you can see for this particular menu, ampersand sign isn't at the beginning, so it's right after the E character, and you want to delete it as well, just like with any other menu, and continue with the process like before. And here, as you can see, Civil view menu doesn't even have ampersand, so what this means is that this will never be activated by Alt modifier key because it doesn't have letter assigned to it. And now, once it's all done, let's check the Alt modifier key. And here you can see no menus popping up, no irritating menus here. And that's it. You can now continue working in 3ds Max with more comfort, hopefully. And speaking of other solutions or supplementary solutions to this solution, you could also use and experiment with AutoHotkey. But I will cover AutoHotkey deeply in following video tutorials. Thank you for watching this video. Press like or dislike and feel free to leave your comments. Also, share this video with others and don't forget to subscribe for more helpful and interesting videos. See you in the future. Bye.